Hello viewers, today we have the second video of the learning board, in which we will see functions of cruise control, high brake, self-learning and reverse. In the previous video we connected the power battery wires, ignition, 3-speed on selector switch, low brake push button and the throttle. So let's start with the high brake. The low brake compared to a high brake has absolutely no difference in their functions. The only difference is the wiring. To activate the high brake, which is usually a single cable, must be connected to the red positive high voltage wire of the battery. While to activate the low brake, which is usually a pair, they must be connected to each other or to any black negative wire of the controller. So let's connect the wiring at this wash and to do electronic brake tests. The green light of selector switch is the fast speed mode. Let's start with the high brake. And now with a low brake. As you can see, the functions are exactly the same. Now let's try to connect reverse mode. The reverse function of the hub motor operates at only 10% of the speed. For safety reasons, to be able to operate at 100% of the speed in the reverse direction, it can be only with the self-study function, which we will see that little bit later. Red light, it means active. The hub motor currently turns clockwise at 100% of the speed. After activating the reverse direction switch, as it is obvious, the motor rotates in reverse and at much lower speeds. And also very important is when to active reverse or forward motor direction, the throttle must be at free position. After the reverse function, we go to cruise control. The cruise control is always a pair of wires which must be connected to each other with the initial speed we want, and then must be disconnected to continue the controller to operate at that speed. So let's connect this function to push button and see how it is work. At the moment, as you can see, the motor spins its own with throttle at free position. Now, to turn off the hub motor, there are three ways. One way is through the same cruise control push button. The second way is with the throttle. The third and the last way is with e-brake. And the last function which we have is self-study. A self-study function does two operations. One is phase learning, which synchronizes the phase of the motor with the controller, and the second is the direction of the motor. Pay attention when we try to adjust the self-study function, because when we connect the cables, the engine will start automatically. So before you do anything with the self-study, make sure the motor or wheel does not touch the ground. soon as we connect the pair of self-study cables, the motor makes a smooth start to synchronize the faces and turns to one direction. Now, to change the direction, we have to disconnect the wires and reconnect them. So now, as you can see, the hub motor turns clockwise. End of the video for today, and see you again.